Oh, yes, for years. I really love her. She's... Oh, she's much more attractive than I am, and she's not scared of anyone. She knows how to handle people and get what she wants.
Oh, she sounds like a good friend to have.
Yes, she is. I wish you could meet her.
Well, maybe one day I will. Let's hope it's not in this joint, eh?
You're very nice, Judy. I'm glad I've met you.
Thanks. Well, time for us to get locked up in our cages. I better go back to mine, huh? I'll see you in the morning.
Sometimes I wish I could go to sleep and never wake up again.
Hey, we'll have no more of that kind of talk. Now, don't you worry, Anne. You're going to be okay. Good night.
Do you reckon those cellars might lead out to somewhere on the outside, Bea?
Could be full of water for all I know.
What do you know? It says here that Wentworth's homestead in the 20s belonged to Squizzy Taylor's right-hand man.
You mean there were crims here even before it was a prison?
I almost met him once.
Who?
Squizzy Taylor. I met a girl who went to a party with a bloke who knew him.
Well, that almost makes you best mates, doesn't it?
Well, what do you reckon all this cleaning up business is about, Bea? I mean, why all of a sudden has everything got to be just right?
I don't know. I've been wondering about that too. I reckon someone must be coming.
To inspect the place, you mean?
Something like that. They certainly want it cleaned up in a hurry.
Yeah.
Gawg! You ought to read about the parties they used to have here.
If I want to read about it, Lizzie, I will. So, meanwhile, why don't you just read about it?
Mm. Oh, bugger it! Just when it was getting interesting. I remember I used to go to big parties like that. I was only a teener then, of course. I was quite a looker. Bit different from now.
It's true, I hope so.
I remember I had this lovely beaded dress. I used to call it me long dress. Come down to me knees.
Do you reckon you could just go to sleep and dream about it, Lizzie, and let us get some sleep too?
Oh, there was lots of booze at them parties. There was bathtubs full of it. And dance. We used to dance all night. The Charleston and the Black Bottom. Oh, you should have seen me then. I could kick up my heels all right. They had some butte songs in those days. Not like the rubbish they have now. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
Shut up, Lizzie!
Hey, do you reckon you really should let someone go down that hole, B? I mean, you don't know what's down there.
Well, we have to find out, don't we? Listen, are you emptying rubbish tins this morning as usual?
Yeah, worse luck.
Well, look, I don't know which screw's on duty, but it doesn't matter. Judy and I and the other women are going to create a diversion, and when we do, I want you to slip down that hole.
But you don't know what's down there.
Well, that's the whole bloody idea, isn't it? I want you to go and have a gander and come back and tell us. Oh, come on, I thought you had some guts. You can borrow my torch if you'd like. You won't be in the dark.
Okay, I'll do it.
Telling me you will. Was I say so? Okay, now the rest of you listen to me. If any of the screws ask where Mouse is when she's down the hole, just say she's somewhere else. If they ask in the kitchen, tell them she's in here. If they ask in here, say she's in the workshop. Anywhere, as long as you say she's somewhere else, okay?
Yeah, give me the old runaround, huh?
That's right. Oh, and about bloody time, too.
Yeah, I'm starving. Starving.
Do you understand that?
Yeah, I do.
What right. Is it?
Oh, oh yeah. Come on, she's so
sick. What is it?
Your mom.
Oh, how did I guess?
Well, we've just about got the whole of H block sparking. Where would you like us to move on to next?
The garden still needs a lot of work. Perhaps these women could assist the ones who are already out there.
Righto, ladies, you can start packing up now and we'll move out to the garden. I don't think you've got any need to worry. If this inspector is fair-minded at all, you'll be able to see that Wentworth's been run very well.
If he's fair-minded. Some of those department inspectors can be very tough.
Well, I'm sure he won't be able to criticise your administration.
Thank you for your support.
All right, ladies, come on. Let's move along now.
Where the hell's Mouse?
Oh, she'll turn up. If she's on garbage duty, she'll have to.
Okay, let's get the cover off.
Straight out of the bed, and I want 2 hours of uninterrupted work. Brant.
What do you think you saw?
Think Schmink, the son of a bitch, nearly bit us.
A big black snake reared up out of the grass at us.
Don't be ridiculous. There are no snakes in this area.
It's possible.
Oh, it's more than possible. It was here. The others saw it, didn't you?
Yes. Well,
then I'm very surprised that it escaped the two of you.
Like it didn't bite you, Vera. It would have died.
I'm going to throw the spank of comics out. I'm going to read them.
Read them? You've read them half a dozen times.
Well, I'll read them again, won't I?
Oh, you in here all on your Pat Malone. Oh, well, we were going to chuck these out, but you can read them if you like.
Oh, I don't feel like reading.
Oh, you have to do something. You can't keep sitting in here with a long face.
I was thinking about my little girl.
You got a daughter?
I had one. She was a beautiful little thing, but she was taken away from me.
Strength. That's what happened to me. They took my kids away. Oh, you poor little thing. I know how you feel.
Yeah, I know what it's like to lose a kid too.
She had biggest blue eyes. She was only 5 months old when her father took her away from me.
Her father? He took her?
Yes. I couldn't stop him. But don't you worry. I'll get her back when I get out of here.
Bloody men. Pity Bee wasn't around. She'd have fixed him.
Must have been awful for you.
It nearly broke my heart. I don't know what I would have done if Megan hadn't have been there to help me over the rough patch.
Oh, you're real lucky to have a good friend like that. But don't you worry. When you get out, you'll find her. You'll be all right.
I hope so.
Yeah, well, Lizzie and me will be your friends while you're in here. Come on, Lizzie. We better go and dump these and get back to the library before old Barry comes looking for us.
I suppose so. Hey, why don't you come into the library and work with us? It's no point in sitting here on your own, Sam.
No, I'm right.
Look, you take these comics and read them. They're real terrific.
Thanks.
I'll get them back off you later.
Oh, yeah. She got to get them back. She's only read them 6 times.
Can I help you?
I have an appointment to see Mrs. Davidson.
Right, sir. If you just make your way through to the inner gate there. If you smiled, your face would split.
Sir?
Yes, my name's Andrew Hunt. I'm here to visit my niece, Phyllis Hunt.
Oh, just one moment. I'm sorry, sir. Phyllis Hunt had a visit from her brother only yesterday. I'm afraid only one visit a week is allowed.
Oh, surely special permission can be arranged. I'm an extremely busy man. It's been most difficult for me to get time to come here today.
I'm afraid there are regulations.
This isn't just a casual visit. It's a matter of great urgency. I insist on seeing my niece.
Well, if you'll wait a moment, I'll see what I can do.